إن أول بيت وضع للناس الذي ببكة. Verily and surely the first house that was built for people, that is for worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the one that is at Bakka. Bakka and Bakka is the same word. Two pronunciations of the same word. Bak, you know, Bak and Bakka, that was the word in Hebrew language for city. You had Baal Bak. Baal Bak was the city of Baal. Baal was one of their gods. You know, so they named that city of Baal, Baal Bak. So Bakka was the city, and this has turned into Bakka. The only pronunciation changes in pronunciation, the city is the same. Inna awwala baytin wudhiya lin-nasi allazi bi Makkata. The first house that was built for people, that is for worship of Allah, is the one that is at Makkah. Mubarakan, that is the blessed one. Wa hudal lil alamin, and it's a source of guidance for all the worlds. Fihi ayatun bayyinat, in that house there are very clear signs, and one of those clear signs is maqam Ibrahim, that stone which was the station for Ibrahim when he was raising the wall of Kaaba. Wa man dakhalahu kana amina, and whosoever enters it, he is in peace, he is in security. This tradition about Baitullah remained intact even during the worst days of Jahiliyyah. There was shirk, there was kufr, everything. But this haram, you know, this was a place of peace and security and tranquility. If you could find the killer and murderer of your own father in that place, the Arabs will never touch him, because this is the place of peace. This is haram, this is for amr. من دخله كان آمنا ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. And it's the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over the people, over the mankind, to perform Hajj of his house, of his home, of his house, حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. Whosoever can make his journey towards it, whosoever can afford the journey. ومن كفر, here again you know the word kufr is used. Whosoever can afford taking journey and he doesn't commit and he doesn't perform Hajj, then as if he is kufr, he is in the kufr, he has committed kufr, because this is farz. And if you are not performing a farz, not fulfilling a duty that has been assigned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means you are denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are refusing to accept him as your Lord and Master. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And whosoever is committing kufr, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't stand in need of anything of the whole world. His ghani, anil alameen, all the worlds. There's no need to be fulfilled for him. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ شَهِيدٌ عَلَى مَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Say to these people of the book, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people of the book, why are you denying Allah? Why are you refusing to accept Allah as your Lord? Why are you denying the ayat of Allah? Wallahu shaheedun ala ma ta'malun. And whatsoever you are doing, Allah Ta'ala is a witness to it. Qul ya ahlal kitab lima tasudduna an sabilillah. Say to them, O people of the book, why are you obstructing the people from the way of Allah? Man amana tabghunahu iwaja. Whosoever comes to believe, you want to create for him conditions of crookedness so that he should turn towards wrong, towards he should go astray from the right path. Vantum shuhada, and you are yourself witnesses that this is the right path. This is actually the deen of Allah. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ أَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is not unaware of what you are doing. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تُطِيعُوا فَرِيقًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ يَرُدُّوكُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ كَافِرِينَ. O you who believe, if you act upon the advices, ita'ah in Arabic means to obey and to act upon the advice of some person also. If you obey these people, some of these peoples whom the book was given before you, the Christians and the Jews, if you obey some of them, or if you act upon their advice, if you lend your ears to them, they will take you back. They will take you back from Iman to Kufr. You will again become kafir. You will again become unbelieving. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تُطِيعُوا فَرِيقًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ يَرُدُّوكُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ كَافِرِينَ فَكَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ. And how dare you commit kufr? How dare you go back from Iman to kufr? وَتُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتُ اللَّهِ. And the ayat of Allah and the signs of Allah are being recited unto you. وَفِيكُمْ رَسُولُهُ. And amongst you is present His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ هُدِيَ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ. And whosoever hold fast to Allah, whosoever clings to Allah, whosoever holds fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed he is guided to the right path, to the straight way. Here the first half of this surah comes to an end. You have seen, just like Surah Al-Baqarah, in the first half, either the direct address is to the former Muslim Ummah, here more prominently to the Christians. In Surah Al-Baqarah, more evidently, more apparently to the Jews, here to the Christians. But after that you had find that Ahlul Kitab, and it includes both. So here also the address mainly has been towards the former Muslim Ummah. And now you know the remaining 10 sections of this surah, starting from ayah number 102 till the end. Here only you will find a very brief reference to the Jews in the very end. But the rest is the address to the Muslim Ummah. And the most part of it that is occupied by a commentary on the events of the Battle of Uhud. But the first two sections are very important, especially the first three ayat. These three ayat, you know, are so profound. And you can compare them to the five ayat of the 19th section of Surah Al-Baqarah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٌ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُم مُّصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. With these five ayats started the second part of the former surah, that is Surah Al-Baqarah, where the address was directed to the Muslim Ummah. Here with three ayat, most profound, the full, you know, a methodology has been given to the Muslim Ummah, how to perform your duty, the duty of becoming witnesses unto the whole of humanity. What should you do? How will you perform? What are the prerequisites? What are the preconditions that you must fulfill to be able to discharge that mission and that duty that has been put on your shoulders? Now first three ayat, and I have a big book, you know, Ummat-e-Muslimah ka laya-e-amal, Quran-e-Hakim ki in teen ayat ki roshni mein. This is in Urdu, a full book on this subject based on these only three ayat.